Wow. David Rush has broken more than 200 Guinness World Records, and last year he set out to break one every week of 2021, which he completed. David has been promoting STEM for years with the goal to inspire students who struggle and let them know that difficult things are indeed impossible. There he is cutting a kiwi with
kiwis.
A samurai.
Yeah.
Wow.
What the heck? David Rush joins us now. Good morning, David.
Hi, David.
Hello, good morning, Larry, Robin. Thanks for having me on.
So you are trained as an engineer. You have a degree from MIT. Do you think it's your science background that's allowing you to tackle some of these world records in a way that other people haven't?
You know, I break these records again to promote STEM education, and I'll talk about the science behind some of the records. And it's more the mindset that allows me to break these records, having a growth mindset, this idea that you can become better at anything if you believe you can and you work hard at it.
So I assume that you weren't spending much time cutting kiwis in half with a samurai sword while you were on a skateboard until you had to break this record, right? So you just practiced?
Yeah, I'm a juggler by trade. I started the juggling club while I was at MIT, and I used that as a hook to tell students about my story of not being smart enough for the Idaho public education system gifted program, and then being able to go off and get my degree from MIT. And then breaking records is just this tangible example that if you set your mind to a goal, believe in yourself and pursue it with a passion, you can accomplish virtually anything. And I didn't practice with the samurai swords until I needed to break a record with them.
Did you just say you started a juggling club at MIT? How does that work? Do you compete against other teams? Do you have matching t-shirts?
I mean, it was a social club where you get together every Friday and Sunday and juggle with each other, swap stories, and it's a great way to relieve the stress of MIT, and it was a great stress reliever.
I'm looking at some of these are unbelievable. How did you decide which records you would try to break?
You know, I just go through the Guinness website and look at all the records with a growth mindset, this idea of I could break any of these. Which ones am I willing to spend the time on?
Yeah.
And be able to, you know, I'm practicing at any given point between 30 and 40 records because it takes weeks or months to build up all the muscle memory to be able to break them.
Okay, so you were practicing for a long time for each of these.
Yeah, some took years to practice. Like the hardest this last year was the fastest 100-meter dash while juggling blindfolded. And you have to stay in your lane. 16.33 seconds sprinting blindfolded in the lane. Years practice.
Wow.
Others didn't take as long.
Look at this marshmallow.
This
what
is great.
Ping pong balls or the shaving cream. I get you. Obviously have
great.
Your friends and family helping you out with this, too.
Yeah, right there. You can see me wrapping my wife in cling wrap, and she was a great support about it, and she does a lot of the timing for the records. So it's a family affair. And this is my son being pushed on a stroller here, fastest 10-meter pram push, wearing all the protective gear to keep him safe.
That's great. Let me ask you. I remember chemistry and physics, and I just felt like I just don't get it. My brain doesn't get that stuff. Is there something to that, or are we being taught the wrong way? Why are there some people who are just geared towards STEM?
You know, there's a little bit of evidence that suggests that, but there's a lot more evidence that what it takes is you have to get over that initial difficulty. Because when you struggle at something, you say, I'm not good at it. And if you have a fixed mindset that things are innate to you and you just have to discover how good you are at them, there's a lot of research that says you won't continue on. But the Khan Academy has published research that shows if you get the students over that initial hump of that initial difficulty, that they can all achieve great things and be academically capable in their life. And breaking these Guinness World Records is another example. People set them up on a pedestal saying, that person has something I can't do. I could never break a Guinness World Records title. And I used to be in that camp. 7 years ago, I was in that camp. But over the last 7 years, I've broken over 200 Guinness World Records titles because I got over that initial hurdle of saying, I could never do that, saying, hey, I can do it, I will do it, and I am doing it now.
Real quickly, you get anything besides a certificate, any cash or anything from Guinness?
Oh, not at all. Just a certificate and sometimes my picture in the book.
All right. Thanks, David.
Thanks, David.
Check out David Rush for STEM.com. You can also find David on social media.
And we couldn't even break one record around
we couldn't.
Here.
Keep up the good work.
We got to practice.
Yeah.
Well, if we all could enroll at MIT, maybe.
Yeah.